Good morning. This is your Warrior News for October 31st, 1996.
At this time, we would like to show you a short video of our appreciation for our new look. Also, a special thank goes to Mr. Johnson, our art teacher, for making the logo for our student desk.
This is Mr. Koblenz's fifth period, second year construction class. A series of students that designed and built this TV studio desk that will be used by the school. I appreciate their hard work and I appreciate the effort that they put into it. I won't go around and introduce all of them, but you can get an idea of who the group was. And I thank them for their work on this. I think they did a nice job.
Students, picture retake today, October 31st. Stop in the office for information.
All cast and crew members involved in Father of the Bride, please check the Drama Club bulletin board daily for schedule change. It is your responsibility to do so.
College representatives from Marion College will be here during fifth period today, located in the surge area across from the auditorium.
Students, have you ever wished you could change the world? You have a chance to try through EF Educational Tours. You need to be able to attend in July of 1997. It's a great opportunity and it's a free scholarship. Check out details in the guidance office.
Gentlemen, if you're interested in making your winter sport of that of a varsity lifter or mascot, practice your toe touch and be ready to do some directed partner stunts and basic tumbling. Tryouts will be held at 6 p.m. on Wednesday, November 6th. Practices begin Monday, November 11th. Sign up with Mrs. Martin by Monday, November 4th to schedule a tryout.
Any student interested in trying out for the girls' gymnastics team or being a team manager should meet with Coach Prather this Friday morning, November 1st at 7:35 p.m. in the cafeteria annex for an informational meeting.
Seniors, the Harriff Jones representatives, Tim and Mark Brezingham, will be here to take our official school graduation announcements and accessory orders. Please do not forget to place your order. They will be here on Friday, November 1st at 8 o'clock a.m. lunch periods at the ticket booth located in the gymnasium, surge area. You must have your $50 or payment in full. Extra packets with order forms are available in the main office.
All boys interested in swimming need to meet in Mr. Carnes room C-111 Friday at 7:20 a.m. Practice begins Monday, November 4th.
Attention all cross country members. Uniforms, sweats, and locks must be turned into the AD's office as soon as possible. Also, any team members wanting to ride in the van to semi-state, please give your name to the AD's office. The van will be leaving around 8 o'clock a.m.
Attention, grade 9, 10, 11, and 12. Friday, November 1st is the press conference day for the school's 1996 election. Press conference is held in the auditorium. Attendance is by each period of the day for students in social studies classes, Mr. Lambert's health classes, and the math departments of teachers who have freshmen. Study hall and HIT students may attend. Bring both political party planks to the press conference. Read and study both planks. Prepare questions to the candidates. Come to the press conference prepared. See you there.
FFA members are reminded of their meeting Monday evening beginning at 7 o'clock p.m. in the AF room. Also, there will be a special officer meeting beginning at 6:25 in the AG room. All officers are expected to attend.
Seniors, tomorrow is it. You must order your cap and gown from the Herf Jones man if you wish to walk at graduation. He will be in the athletic lobby ticket booth from 7:30 to 1 p.m.
Market day forms are available to students in the main office and staff for the classroom distribution in the mailroom.
With our closing, we will be showing you an optional video from our TV production advanced speech class. Have a great Warrior Day.
Hold it. Listen.
Can't get next to you, baby. Can't get next to you.
season went really good. We progressed a lot. We all really wanted to try to get our sectional, and I think we all had fun pretty much.
Say what you feel.
We had one of our best seasons ever. Was disappointing to lose the Warsaw sectional, but I know next year's guys will come back and have to beat them real bad as a little revenge. And it was a good season all in all. Hopefully I'll get to continue my soccer career in college, but as for right now, it's unknown.
I think soccer is a more dangerous sport than football because there's a lot more injuries because there's no pads. You're going full out the whole game for 80 minutes, and I would know I broke my foot because I kicked the goalie's knee. And we were 6-7-3 this year. We only lost one game by 3, and all the rest were by 2 or less. So, and Ori's a great captain.
What about those yellow cards?
I had 2 in 4 games that I played. The sky blew up. I can make it rain whenever I wanted to.
Good morning. This is your Warrior News for November 1st, 1996. I'm Therese Lundin.
And I'm Leanne Gerber. Student, have you ever wished you could change the world? You have a chance to try through EF Educational Tours. You need to be able to attend in July of 1997. It's a great opportunity and it's a free scholarship. Check out details in the guidance office.
Gentlemen, if you are interested in making your winter sport that of a varsity lifter or mascot, practice your toe touch and be ready to do some directed partner stunts and basic tumbling. Tryouts will be held at 6 p.m. on Wednesday, November 6th. Practices begin on Monday, November 11th. Sign up with Mrs. Martin by Monday, November 4th to schedule a tryout.
All boys interested in swimming need to meet in Mr. Khan's room, C11, Friday at 7:20 a.m. Practice begins Monday, November 4th.
Attention all cross-country members, uniforms, sweats, and locks must be turned in to the AD's office as soon as possible. Also, any team members wanting to ride in the van to semi-state, please give your name to the AD's office. The van will be leaving around 8 a.m.
Attention, grades 9 through 12. Today, November 1st, is the first press conference day for the school's 1996 election. Press conference is held in the auditorium. Attendance is by each period of the day for student and social studies classes, Mr. Lambert's health classes, the math departments of teachers who have freshmen. Study hall and his students may attend. Bring both political party plank to the press conference. Read and study both planks. Prepare questions to the candidates. Come to the press conference prepared. See you there.
FFA members are reminded of their meeting Monday evening beginning at 7 p.m. in the AF room. Also, there will be a special officer meeting beginning at 6:25 in the Ag office. All officers are expected to attend.
Seniors, today is it. You must order your cap and gown from the Harriff Jones man if you wish to walk at graduation. He will be in the athletic lobby ticket booth from 7:30 to 1.
Seniors, the Harriff Jones representatives, Tim and Mark Bresnahan, will be here to take your official school graduation announcements and accessory orders. Please do not forget to place your order. They will be here on Friday, November 1st at 8 a.m. Lunch periods at the ticket booth located in the gymnasium, surge area. You must have your $50 or payment in full. Extra packets with order forms are available in the main office.
Market day forms are available to students in the main office and staff for classroom distribution in the mailroom.
The American Legion is once again sponsoring a speech contest. Speakers can win up to $20,000 in scholarships. See Ms. Woldridge for details.
Attention, all FEA members. Parent permission slips must be turned in by Wednesday, November 6th, if you want to participate in Observation Day at the elementary and middle schools. Turn your slips in to Amy Coburn or Mr. Iden.
Wawasee Intramural Basketball League starts Tuesday, November 19th. Sign-up sheets are in the main office.
Father of the Bride Stagecraft Crew, it's time to get to work. Be in the auditorium Tuesday and Thursday at 3:15. Father Extras, you must be at Father Father the Bride Stagecraft Crew. It's time to get to work. Be in the auditorium Tuesday and Thursday at 3:15. Father Extras, you must be at every rehearsal from now on. We're ready to put you in.
Father Backstage Crew, Monday begins your full-time job. We need you to be at every rehearsal. Next Monday will be early dismissal for students at 12:30 p.m.
To all students, on Wednesday and Thursday, November 6th and 7th, all of you will be in TAP testing period 1 through 4. Be sure to know your room assignments and come prepared with at least 2 number 2 sharpened pencils and extra reading material.
All soccer, cross country, and volleyball players, please stop in the athletic office sometime today.
The cheerleaders and lifters bus will leave at 5 p.m. sharp tonight. In order to be a part of the Trail to Goshen, please be on the bus before 5. Thank you, Mrs. Martin.
Good luck to our Wawasee Warrior football team. Beat Goshen High School tonight. That is all for your Warrior News. Have a great week, great weekend. Now back live to the press conference. Vote Citizen 96, Chris and John, woo!
Good morning. Welcome to your Warrior News for November 4th, 1996. At this time, we'd like to go to a special message from Pat McCulley.
Congratulations to the Wawasee Marching Warrior Pride. We finished a very successful season last Saturday by placing seventh in our class at a Bands of America regional competition held in the RCA Hoosier Dome in Indianapolis. The competition had 32 bands, and we finished 26th. Finest bands from Indiana, Illinois, Ohio, Kentucky, Tennessee, and Michigan were at the RCA Dome. The band gave their best performance of the year. We wish to congratulate them on their outstanding efforts this year. Great job, Marching Warrior Pride.
Thanks, Pat. Today after school, 9th grade boys basketball practice will be at 4:45, and 10th and 12th grade practices will be at 3:05. Julie Glahn, Dina Coverstone, please see Mrs. Pletcher today. And juniors, your sales money is due by Wednesday of this week. It should be deposited in the box in Mrs. Pletcher's room.
Baseball weight training will be Tuesday at 4:30. This is a time change.
Student, have you ever wished you could change the world? You have a chance to try through EF Educational Tours. You need to be able to attend in July of 1997. It's a great opportunity and it's a free scholarship. Check out details in the guidance office.
Gentlemen, if you're interested in making your winter sport that of a varsity lifter or mascot, practice your toe touch and be ready to do some directed partner stunts and basic tumbling. Tryouts will be held at 6 p.m. on Wednesday, November 6th. Practice begins on Monday, November 11th. Sign up with Mrs. Martin today, November 4th, to schedule a tryout.
FFA members are reminded of their meeting today beginning at 7 o'clock p.m. in the Ag Room. Also, there will be a special officer meeting beginning at 6:25 in the Ag Office. All officers are expected to attend.
Market day forms are available to students in the main office and staff for classroom distribution in the mailroom.
The American Legion is once again sponsoring a speech contest. Speakers can win up to $20,000 in scholarships. See Ms. Wooldridge if you have for the details.
Attention all FEA members. Parent permission slips must be turned in by Wednesday, November 6th if you want to participate in observation day at the elementary and middle schools. Turn your slips in to Amy Coburn or Mr. Iden.
Wawasee Intramural Basketball League starts Tuesday, November 19th. Sign-up sheet are in the main office.
Father of the Bride Stagecraft Crew, it's time to get to work. Be in the auditorium Tuesday and Thursday at 3:15. Father Extras, you must be at every rehearsal from now on. We're ready to put you in.
Father Backstage Crew, Monday begins your full-time job. We need you to be at every rehearsal. Today will be early dismissal for students at 12:30 p.m.
To all students, on Wednesday and Thursday, November 6th and 7th, all of you will be in TAP testing periods 1 through 4. Be sure you know your room assignments and come prepared with at least 2 number 2 sharpened pencils and extra reading materials.
All 3 cheer squads performed well at the Indiana Cheer Association's Northern Regional Competition. By virtue or placing in the top 3 in their division, the varsity squad will go on to the state contest in 2 weeks.
To faculty only, in response to your TAP concerns about pencil sharpeners, the custodian will check them out if you let me know today which sharpeners do not work. Get a note to Ruth Engel with your name and room number, and they will try to follow through by Wednesday.
Now at this time, we would like to show you an optional video from our TV production advanced speech class. Have a great Warrior Week.
Next week,
we're passing out ribbons and pencils for everyone, and that's
about all. We're just getting ready for Red Ribbon Week. Okay. Carrie. So, Carrie, where do you guys meet your room?
Every, on Group C days, we go into the boardroom, and we meet, and we just have a meeting for what we're doing, what we're planning. And the people that sponsor us are Mr. Whitaker and Ms. Ritter.
Wow, that's great. Hi guys, what do you guys normally do in your normal meetings?
My name is Rod Holtzman. I'm president and SAD. In our meetings, we usually make plans for upcoming events. And October 21st through the 23rd is SAD Week, so all students, please help out with SAD Week by getting a pencil at lunch. And on Wednesday the 23rd, please wear red to school, standing against drug-free.
I'm Ryan Johnson, vice president. Basically, during the meetings, we just decorate the school and talk about upcoming events.
There you have it, folks. Sad.
Why did you decide to be the SAD club sponsor?
Well, last year, Mrs. Holferman approached me and asked me if I would be interested in helping out because they needed someone who was willing to take partial responsibility in leading the club, and I was a SAD member in high school and thought that that sounded like a good way that I could help serve the student body and be supportive of that.
And what do you like best about being the sponsor?
I think the thing I like most is that students are standing up and taking some responsibility for something that's right, making a pledge not to drink and drive, and wanting to speak out against irresponsible choices. That's rewarding.
And could you describe the type of pledge they make when they join SAD?
They sign a contract for life, which basically states that they agree not to drive while under the influence or ride with someone who is under the influence, and they are also encouraged to abstain from alcohol. There is a spot for them to sign the pledge as well as their parents, and that they have an agreement with their parents that they can call home at any time if they are in a situation where they will not be guaranteed a safe ride home.
Well, that's really great. Thanks, Ms. Redder.
You're welcome.
And please join SAD if you feel like you can make the pledge, and it meets during Group C in the boardroom. Thank you.
Good morning, this is your Warrior News for November 5th, 1996. Now from a message from Teresa Lundeen.
Hello, I'm Teresa Lundeen. I'm the 1996 National Chairperson for the Citizens Party. First of all, I'd like to thank Mr. Johnson for creating our turtle mascot. A very special thank you to Mrs. Christoffel, Ben Plicker, Nathan Rogers, and the rest of the production staff who did an excellent job with our video, the press conference, and the convention. I'd also like to thank all the national chairs for their support and the rest of the Citizens Party for their hard work and cooperation. Thanks again for all the help these past 3 weeks.
And from the Republican side, I'd also like to thank all those that aided in the Republican platform and everything that went into this convention. Thank you.
Sean. Gentlemen, if you're interested in making your winter sport that of a varsity lifter or mascot, practice toe touch and be ready to do some directed partner stunts and basic tumbling. Tryouts will be held at 6 p.m. on Wednesday, November 6th. Practices begin on Monday, November 11th.
Gymnastics team tryouts will begin Monday, November 11th. Athletes need to be in the PE Annex no later than 3:15 p.m.
Cross-country team members must turn in uniform and sweats by November 13th to the athletic office. Not doing so will hold up the awards.
There's a general SRC meeting next Wednesday morning at 7:15.
Market day forms are available to students in the main office and staff for classroom distribution in the mailroom.
The American Legion is once again sponsoring a speech contest. Speakers can win up to $20,000 in scholarships. See Mrs. Wooldridge for details.
Attention, all FEA members, parent permission slips must be turned in by Wednesday, November 6th, if you want to participate in observation day at the elementary and middle schools. Turn your slips in to Amy Coburn or Mr. Iden.
Wawasee Intramural Basketball League starts Tuesday, November 19th. Sign-up sheets are in the main office.
Follow the Bride Stagecraft crew. It's time to get World. Be in the auditorium Tuesday and Thursday at 3:15. Father Extras, you must be at every rehearsal from now on. We're ready to put you in.
Father Backstage crew, Monday begins your full-time job. We need you at every rehearsal.
To all students on Wednesday and Thursday, November 6th and 7th, all of you will be in TAP testing, period 1 through 4. Be sure to know your room assignments and come prepared with at least two Number two, sharpened pencils and extra reading material.
If you're late to school Wednesday or Thursday morning, you must report to the attendance office for a pass and you will need to make up any test missed.
Juniors, your sales money is due by Wednesday of this week. It should be deposited in the box in Ms. Pletcher's room.
All freshman football players and managers need to see Coach Van Loo before Friday, November 8th. The LRC will be preparing overdue notices today. Please return or renew any material before the end of fifth period today.
We will have two college visits this week. Wednesday, St. Mary's will be here during fifth period, and on Thursday, a representative from Indiana University of South Bend, that will be IUSB. They will be located all of fifth period in the surgery across from the auditorium.
That's all for your Warrior News, and have a great week. Get plenty of rest and be ready for the TAP testing these next 2 days.
Hi, I'm Zach Warren.
And I'm Abby Weiss.
Good morning. This is your Warrior News for November 8th, 1996.
The American Legion is once again sponsoring a speech contest. Speakers can win up to $20,000 in scholarships. See Ms. Woolridge for details.
Wawasee Intramural Basketball League starts Tuesday, November 19th. Sign-up sheet are in the main office.
All freshman football players and managers need to see Coach Van Loo by today, November 8th.
Sophomores, deadline for nomination application for the Hugh O'Brien Leadership Conference today, November 8th. Application must be turned in at the guidance office by 3 p.m.
The wedding of the year on November 22nd and 23rd at 7 o'clock p.m. Buy your tickets to Father of the Bride for Mrs. Thornburg in A115 before or after school. Tickets are all $3.
Girls basketball jamboree will be held at Tiger Den Warsaw Community High School on November 12, 1996 at 7 p.m. Tickets are $3 at the door and can be purchased at the athletic department.
Cross-country team members must turn in your uniform and sweats by November 13th to the athletic office. If you do not turn in your uniform and sweats in, you will not receive your awards.
Gymnastics team tryouts will be coming this Monday, November 11th. Athletes need to be in the PE annex no later than 3:15.
Cheerleaders and lifters going to Butler tomorrow are reminded that we will leave at 5 a.m. NHS inductors should be present in the auditorium at 6:30 p.m. Monday evening. A publicity picture will be taken.
Current NHS members who didn't pick up their messages yesterday, please do so today. Tiffany Lay, please see Mrs. Leach today.
To all sophomores and juniors, the University of South Florida is offering a summer program in math and science for high school ability students. These are pre-college courses in math, biology, chemistry, and computer science. Applications are due by March 15th. See your guidance counselor for details.
Juniors, area McDonald's restaurants are offering a McDonald's Black History Makers of Tomorrow scholarship. This is an excellent scholarship offered to local students. For details, ask Mrs. Engel.
Any upperclassmen interested in being a statistician for the JV or varsity basketball team, please sign up in the main office. You only have to attend games. Seniors, there will be a general college financial aid meeting on Tuesday at 7 p.m. in the lecture room. Parents invited.
Any freshmen interested in being a statistician for a freshman basketball team, please sign up in the main office. You only have to go to games.
There will be a mandatory meeting for all boys and girls interested in being in track this spring at 7:30 a.m. next week, Thursday morning, in Coach Murphy's room, B224.
Key Club, your help is needed at the Syracuse Elementary Fall Festival tonight. If you can help from 1 to 3 hours or from 5 to 8, see Ms. Pletcher for details. Also, Key Club will visit Wawasee Kiwanis at 6:45. a.m. tomorrow morning. If you'd like to be a part of this inner club, see Ms. Pletcher today.
Juniors, your sale money and unsold items should be turned in to Mrs. Pletcher. They are past due.
Seniors, today is your last day to order a senior shirt. See Mrs. Leach if you still need to order one.
Now at this time, we would like to share with you an optional video of our Warrior Band that competed this past weekend.
High School is the Wawasee High School Marching Band from Syracuse, Indiana. Wawasee's musical selections include Selections from Carmen.
To be or not to be. Target that explosion and fire.
Fire!
Fire!
Good morning. Welcome to your Warrior News for November 11th, 1996. At this time, we're going to honor Veterans Day, and I'm going to read something, okay? As America looks back on more than two centuries of freedom and progress, we see a common thread woven through the tapestry of our history, the dedication of men and women who have served our nation in the armed forces. While we never forget their service on their sacrifice, each year at this time we remember with special gratitude the courage, commitment, and devotion to the duty of Americans' veterans. Veterans Day reminds all Americans that the values we hold so dear are preserved at a price. From our earliest days as a nation, our armed forces have fought to secure these blessings, advancing peace, liberty, and prosperity, while ensuring the safety of our families and communities. Time and again, our veterans have put themselves on the line, risking and sometimes losing their lives in defense of democracy, protecting our borders with skill, diligence, and integrity, and restoring hope and opportunity around the globe. Because of their selfless efforts, America remains a beacon of freedom and a land of promise to peoples around the world. As we stand on the threshold of a new century, let us recall the enduring legacy of our nation's veterans. With quiet valor and abiding faith, they have answered every call to duty, met every challenge to our independence, and strengthened the spirit of our nation. The finest tribute we can pay to them today is to ensure that coming generations of Americans honor their memory by carrying on their tradition of steadfast service. All award jackets must be paid for by tomorrow, November 12th. Please drop off your money at the athletic office. Boys basketball jamboree will be held at Warsaw High School on Saturday, November 16th at 7:30 p.m. Tickets are $3 at the door and $3 pre-sale. Tickets can be purchased from the athletic department. Teresa Lundeen, please stop by the athletic office at your convenience. The following boys have messages in the office: Chris Baumgartner, Dan Sawyer, Toby Whitmer, Dave Mahan, Tom Bryan, and Todd Lovelick.
Drama Club members, check the bulletin board for new items needed for the play and reception. We need your help. There is an excellent opportunity for any student who might be interested in a career in the journalism or media field. It's a summer workshop. It does not cost, and it is in Los Angeles, California. But it's an excellent chance to explore media careers and meet media professionals. Check in the guidance office for more details.
The American Legion is once again sponsoring a speech contest. Speakers can win up to $20,000 in scholarships. See Ms. Wooldridge for details.
Wawasee Intramural Basketball League starts Tuesday, November 19th. Sign-up sheet is in the main office.
The wedding of the year is on November 22nd and 23rd at 7 o'clock p.m. Buy your tickets to Father of the Bride from Mrs. Thornburg in A115 before or after school. Tickets are all $3.
Girls Basketball Jamboree will be held at the Tiger Den, Warsaw Community High School on November 12, 1996 at 7 p.m. Tickets are $3 at the door and can be purchased from the athletic department.
Cross-country team members must turn in your uniform and sweats by November 13th to the athletic office. If you do not turn in your uniform and sweats, you will not receive your awards.
Gymnastics team tryouts will be this coming Tuesday, November 11th. Athletes need to be in the PE Annex no later than 3:15 p.m.
NHS inductors should be present in the auditorium at 6:30 p.m. this evening. A publicity picture will be taken.
To all sophomores and juniors, the University of South Florida is offering a summer program in math and science for high ability students. These are college courses in math, biology, chemistry, and computer science. Applications are due by March 15th. See your guidance counselor for more details.
To juniors, area McDonald's restaurants are offering a McDonald's Black History Makers of Tomorrow scholarship. This is an excellent scholarship offered to local students. For details, see Ms. Engel.
Any upperclassmen interested in becoming a statistician for the JV or varsity basketball team, please sign up in the main office. You only have to attend games. Seniors, there will be a general college financial aid meeting on Tuesday at 7 p.m. in the lecture room. Parents are invited.
Any freshman interested in being a statistician for the freshman basketball team, please sign up in the main office. You only have to go to games also.
There will be a mandatory meeting for all boys and girls interested in being in track this spring at 7:30 a.m. this week, Thursday morning, in Coach Murphy's room, B224.
FCA tomorrow, Tuesday morning at 7 o'clock a.m. in the PE health room.
That's all for your Warrior News, and have a great week.
Good morning, this is your Warrior News for November 12, 1996.
Wawasee Intramural Basketball League starts Tuesday, November 19th. Sign-up sheet are in the main office.
The Wedding of the Year is November 22nd and 23rd at 7 o'clock p.m. Buy our tickets to Father of the Bride at Mrs. Thornburg's room in A115 or after school. Tickets are $3.
Girls Basketball Jamboree will be held in the Tiger Den Warsaw Community High School today, November 12, 1996 at 7 p.m. Tickets are $3 at the door and can be purchased from the athletic department. Come out and support them.
The cross-country team members must turn in your uniform and sweats by November 13th to the athletic office. If you do not turn in your uniform and sweats, you will not receive your awards.
To all sophomore and juniors, the University of South Florida is offering a summer program in math and science for high school ability students. These are pre-college courses in math, biology, chemistry, and computer science. Applications are due by March 15th. See your guidance counselor for details.
To juniors, area McDonald's restaurants are offering a McDonald's Black History Makers of Tomorrow scholarship. This is an excellent scholarship offered to local students. For details, see Mrs. Engel.
Any upperclassmen interested in being a statistician for the JV or varsity basketball team, please sign up in the main office. You only have to attend the games. Seniors, there will be a general college financial aid meeting tonight at 7 p.m. in the lecture room. Parents are invited.
Any freshman interested in being a statistician for the freshman basketball team, please sign up in the main office. You only have to go to games also.
There will be a mandatory meeting for all boys and girls interested in being in track this spring at 7:30 a.m. this week, Thursday morning, in Coach Murphy's room, B224.
Now to an earlier sky cam shot that we grabbed for you. Here's our Warrior forecast for the next 2 days. Isn't that a nice picture?
Sure is.
Tuesday, partly sunny. Today, high of 32. Wednesday, partly sunny, highs in the mid-30s.
Juniors, the salesman will settle our account tomorrow and buy back all returned items. No returns will be accepted after tomorrow. You have to pay for them yourself if you don't get to Miss Pletcher tomorrow by noon.
Today, college representatives from Ivy Tech. Warsaw is here. Drama club members, check the bulletin board for new items needed for the play and reception. We need your help.
There's an excellent opportunity for any student who might be interested in a career in journalism or media field. It's a summer workshop. It does cost, and it is in Los Angeles, California, but it's an excellent chance to explore media careers and meet media professions. Check in the guidance office for more details. The LRC will be preparing overdue notices today. Please return or renew your material before the end of the fifth period today.
The following students need to stop by the athletic department to pick up or sign for physicals: Jonathan Brock, Gretchen Kripe, Aaron Drum, John Glover, Sarah Losey, Ross Hensler, Olivia Patterson. And there's also a general SRC meeting at 7:10 tomorrow in Mrs. Leach's room. See you there.
That is all for your Warrior News. Have a great Warrior Week.
What are they doing?
What are you guys doing over there?
Thank you.
morning. This is your Warrior News for November 13, 1996. The following students need to stop by the athletic office department to pick up signed physicals: Jonathan Brock, Gretchen Kripe, Aaron Drum, John Clover, Sarah Losey, and Ross Hensler. The following students need to stop by the athletic department before the end of the day: Bryce Schaefer, Chauncey Wiggs, Alicia Holderman, John Fleece, Aaron McFarlane, and John Mock.
The class rings have arrived. Rings will be handed out on Thursday, November 21st, during lunch hours. Your balance due must be paid to get your ring. This will be the only delivery day. Also, rings can be ordered with a $50 deposit. Samples will be on display.
Wawasee Intramural Basketball League starts Tuesday, November 19th. Sign-up sheets are in the main office.
The wedding of the year is on November 22nd and 23rd at 7 o'clock p.m. Buy your tickets to Father of the Bride from Mrs. Thornburg in A115 before or after school. Tickets are all $3.
Cross-country team members must turn in your uniform and sweats by today, November 13th, to the athletic office. If you do not turn in your uniform and sweats, you will not receive your awards.
To all sophomore and juniors of the varsity, to all sophomore and juniors, the University of South Florida is offering a summer program in math and science for high ability students. These are pre-college courses in math, biology, chemistry, and computer science. Applications are due by March 15th. See your guidance counselor for details.
To juniors, area McDonald's restaurants are offering the McDonald's Black History Makers of Tomorrow Scholarship. This is an excellent scholarship offered to local students. For details, see Mrs. Engel.
Any upperclassmen interested in being a statistician for the JV or varsity basketball team, please sign up in the main office. You only have to attend games.
Any freshmen interested in being a statistician for the freshman basketball team, please sign up in the main office. You only have to go to the games also.
There will be a mandatory meeting for all boys and girls interested in being in track this spring at 7:30 a.m. tomorrow morning. It will be in Coach Murphy's room, B224.
Juniors, the salesman will settle our account today and buy back all returned items. No returns will be accepted after today. You will have to pay for them yourselves if you do not see Mrs. Pletcher by today at noon.
Drama Club members, check the bulletin board for new items needed for the play and reception. We need your help.
There is an excellent opportunity for any student who might be interested in a career in journalism or the media field. It's a summer workshop, and it does cost, and it is in Los Angeles, California. But it is an excellent chance to explore media careers and meet media professionals. Check in the guidance office for more details.
Students are only to take a level boat of... Students are only to take a level boat of French fries during lunch. If this rule is ignored by students, French fries will be discontinued from the lunch lines. If additional amount of food is taken, be sure you have extra money to pay cashier.
Boys basketball jamboree will be held at Warsaw High School Saturday, November 16th at 7:30. Okay. Tickets are $3 at the door and $3 pre-sale. Tickets can be purchased from the athletic department.
The athletic department's Fall Sports Awards program will be held on November 14th starting at 6:30 p.m. in the Commons area. Okay. Students who were selected to compete on academic Super Bowl teams or study groups should meet with Mrs. Lant November 20th at 3 o'clock.
That's all for your Warrior News, and have a great Warrior Day.
Don't come any closer than that!
Just go through and brand, soon we'll be
something strange in the neighborhood.
Warrior News for November 14th, 1996.
Wawasee Intramural Basketball League starts Tuesday, November 19th. Sign-up sheet is in the main office.
The Wedding of the Year is on November 22nd and 23rd at 7 o'clock p.m. Buy your tickets to Father of the Bride from Mrs. Thornburg in A115 before or after school. Tickets are all $3.
To all sophomores and juniors, the University of South Florida is offering a summer program in math and science for high school ability students. These are pre-college courses in math, biology, chemistry, and computer science. Applications are due by March 15th. See your guidance counselor for details.
To juniors, area McDonald's restaurants are offering a McDonald's Black History Makers of Tomorrow scholarship. This is an excellent scholarship offered to local students. For details, see Mrs. Engel.
Any upperclassmen interested in being a statistician for the JV or varsity basketball team, please sign up in the main office. You only have to attend the games.
Any freshman interested in being a statistician for the freshman basketball team, please sign up in the main office also. You only have to go to games.
Drama Club members, check the bulletin board for new items needed for the play and reception. We need your help.
There's an excellent opportunity for any student who might be interested in a career in the field of journalism or media. It is a summer workshop and it does cost. It is in Los Angeles, California, but it is an excellent chance to explore the media careers and meet media professionals. Check in the guidance office for more details.
Students are only to have to take a level bowl of French fries during lunch period. If this rule is ignored by students, French fries will be discontinued from lunch lines. If additional amount of food is taken, be sure you have extra money to pay the cashier.
Boys Basketball Jamboree will be held at Warsaw High School on Saturday, November 16th at 7:30 p.m. Tickets are $3 at the door and $3 pre-sale. Tickets can be purchased from the athletic department.
The athletic department's Fall Sports Awards program will be held on November 14th starting at 6:30 p.m. in the Commons area. Students who are selected to compete on the academic Super Bowl teams or study groups should meet with Mrs. Lant November 20th at 3 p.m. in her room.
The class rings have arrived. Rings will be handed out on Tuesday, November 21st during the lunch hours. Your balance must be paid in full to get your ring. This will be the only delivery day. Also, rings can be ordered with a $50 deposit. Samples will be on display.
Father of the Bride tickets go on sale at lunch next week. Every ticket is $3. Be sure to get a ticket for all the fun on November 22nd and 23rd.
All Wawasee varsity and JV soccer players need to stop at Mrs. Thornburg's room A115 sometime today.
That is all for your Warrior News. Have a great Warrior Day.
Good morning, this is your Warrior News for November 15th, 1996.
Wawasee Intramural Basketball League starts Tuesday, November 19th. Sign-up sheets are in the main office.
The Wedding of the Year is on November 22nd and 23rd at 7 p.m. Buy your tickets to Father of the Bride from Mrs. Thornburg in A115 before or after school. Tickets are all $3.
To all sophomores and juniors, the University of South Florida is offering a summer program in math and science for high school ability students. These are pre-college courses in math, biology, chemistry, and computer science. Applications are due by March 15th. See your guidance counselor for more details.
To juniors, area McDonald's restaurants are offering a McDonald's Black History Makers of Tomorrow scholarship. This is an excellent scholarship offered to local students. For details, see Ms. Engel.
Any upperclassmen interested in being a statistician for the JV or varsity basketball team, please sign up in the main office. You only have to attend games.
Any freshman interested in being a statistician for the freshman basketball team, please sign up in the main office. You only have to go to games.
Drama Club members, check the bulletin board for new items needed for the play and reception. We need your help.
There's an excellent opportunity for any student who might be interested in a career in journalism or media field. It's a summer workshop. It does cost, and it is in Los Angeles, California. But it's an excellent chance to explore media careers and meet media. Check in the guidance office for more details.
Students are only to take a level boat of French fries during lunch. If this rule is ignored by students, French fries will be discontinued from the lunch lines. If additional amount of food is taken, be sure you have extra money to pay the cashier.
Boys basketball Jamboree will be held at Warsaw High School on Saturday, November 16th at 7:30 p.m. Tickets are $3 at the door and $3 pre-sale. Tickets can be purchased from the athletic department.
The athletic department's fall sports program was yesterday. Students who were selected to compete on academic Super Bowl teams or study groups should meet with Mrs. Lant November 20th at 3 p.m.
The class rings have arrived. Rings will be handed out on Tuesday, November 21st during lunch hours. Your balance must be paid to get your ring. This will be the only delivery day. Also, rings can be ordered with a $50 deposit. Samples will be on display.
Father the Bride tickets go on sale at lunch next week. Every ticket is $3. Be sure to get a ticket for all the fun on November 23rd and 22nd.
All Wawasee varsity and JV soccer players need to stop by Mrs. Thornburg's room, A115, sometime today.
A big thank you to drama clubbers who attended the Joseph Field trip yesterday. Not only was Donnie Osmond excellent, but was also your behavior. Miss Woldridge also reminds everyone of tomorrow's work day at 9 o'clock a.m. Bring a wrap gift and some cans of pop.
That's all for your Warrior News. Have a great day. Good morning. This is your Warrior News for November 18th, 1996.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Christoffel. Go ahead.
Wawasee Intramural Basketball League starts tomorrow, November 19th. Hopefully you have signed up your teams by now.
The Wedding of the Year is on November 22nd and 23rd at 7 p.m. Buy your tickets to Father the Bride from Mrs. Thornburg and A115 before or after school. Tickets are $3.
To all sophomores and juniors, the University of South Florida is offering a summer program in math and science for high ability students. These are pre-college courses in math, biology, chemistry, and computer science. Applications are due by March 15th. See your guidance counselor for details.
To juniors, area McDonald's restaurants are offering a McDonald's Black History Makers of Tomorrow scholarship. This is an excellent scholarship offered to local students. For details, see Ms. Engel.
Drama Club members, check the bulletin board for new items needed for the play and reception. We need your help.
Wawasee Girls Varsity, which at this time we will show you, Wawasee Girls Varsity and JV basketball teams opened their season on Friday night at Westview. Both teams came away with a victory. JV's victory was a 33-12 against Westview, and Varsity was a 60-33 victory also. Next action is this coming Thursday at Elkhart Memorial.
There's an excellent opportunity for any student who might be interested in a career in journalism or media field. It's a summer workshop. It does cost and it is in Los Angeles, but it's an excellent chance to explore media careers and meet media.
Check in the guidance office for more details.
The class rings have arrived. Rings will be handed out on Tuesday, November 21st during lunch hours. Your balance must be paid to get your ring. This will be only delivery day available. Also, rings can be ordered with a $50 deposit. Samples will be on display.
The girls' swim team opened their season with a 113-70 victory over DeKalb. First place finishers for the Warriors were Laura Lundeen, Stacy Nogler and Jenny Marty, and Christine Shivers, Jennifer Ganshorn, Carrie Grothaus, and Stacy Kraft. The swimmers host Penn this Thursday at WMS.
That's Wawasee Middle School. Students who were selected to compete at academic Super Bowl teams or study groups should meet with Mrs. Land in A-159 this coming Wednesday, November 20th at 3 p.m. Please be prompt.
The following students need to stop by the athletic department to pick up or sign physicals: Gretchen Kripe, Aaron Drum, John Gulver, and Ross Hensler.
Kyle Swihart, Heather Morgan, Matt Engelbert, Brad Andrews, Heather Lavernier, Ron Rucker, Ben Ashbow, Zach Bowen, Alina List, Jackie Stanton, Amber Hoover, and Amy Goldmeyer, please stop by the athletic office.
Boys and girls swim team members, you are to be at practice at 3:30 p.m. at Wawasee Middle School. Be prompt.
That's all for your Warrior News, and congratulations to Ball State University for winning the MAC championship. Have a great day.
Yes, sir.
The Stay Puft Marshmallow Man. Something you don't see every day.
Good morning. This is your Warrior News from November 19th, 1996.
Wawasee Intramural Basketball League starts today, November 19th. Hopefully you have signed up your teams by now.
The wedding of the year is on November 22nd and 23rd at 7 p.m. Buy your tickets to Follow the Bride from Mrs. Thornburg in A-115 before or after school. Tickets are all $3.
To all sophomores and juniors, the University of South Florida is offering a summer program in math and science for high school ability students. These are pre-college courses in math, biology, chemistry, and computer science. Applications are due by March 15th. See your guidance counselor for details.
To juniors, area McDonald's restaurants are offering a McDonald's Black History Makers of Tomorrow scholarship. This is an excellent scholarship offered to local students. For details, see Mrs. Engel.
Drama Club members, check the bulletin board for new items needed for the play and reception. We need your help.
This is an excellent opportunity for any student who might be interested in a career in the journalism or medical field. It's a summer workshop. It does cost, and it is in Los Angeles, California, but it's an excellent chance to explore media careers and meet media professionals. Check in the guidance office for more details.
Class rings have arrived. Rings will be handed out on Thursday, November 21st during lunch hours. Your balance must be paid to get your ring. This will be the only delivery date. Also, rings can be ordered with a $50 deposit. Samples will be on display.
Students who were selected to compete in academic Super Bowl teams or study groups should meet with Mrs. Land, A-159, this Wednesday, November 20th at 3 p.m.
The following students need to stop by the athletic department to pick up or sign physicals: Gretchen Kripe, Aaron Drum, John Glover, Ron Rucker, Ben Ashpol, Ross Hensler, Zach Boren, Alina List, Jackie Stinton, and Amber Hoover. Please stop by the athletic department. The LRC will be preparing overdue notices today. Please return or renew your material before the end of fifth period today.
Listen carefully. Mrs. Moss's fifth period study hall will not meet in the lecture room today. All fifth period study hall students should report to the auditorium today.
This is the second day of American Education Week, and the theme for this week is The Lecture Begins in Tuesday's Schools. Today we would like to recognize all of our custodians and cafeteria personnel that work at Wawasee High School and say thanks for all that they do. Thank you. You're the best.
Key Club News. You have a meeting tonight at 6:30. We are expecting guests from other clubs. Please try to attend. It will last from 6:30 to 7:15 in Mrs. Pletcher's room. Key Club members who want to be part of upcoming projects should meet during homeroom tomorrow if you are not in Club C. Projects being worked on with Big Brothers and Sisters, the Red Cross, Blowmobile, and Penny Pitch. Reminder, Market Day pickup will be tomorrow, Wednesday.
Swim practice for you boys and girls will be at the middle school today. Now at this time, we have an optional video. That is all for your Warrior News. Have a great Warrior Day.
hope we're not like on the news right now. And everybody's just looking at us. We're stupid. God, this ice hurt my eyes.
Morning. This is your Warrior News for November 20th, 1996. Mr. Warren would like to meet with the following students during homeroom today. Gunther Krebs, Shad Kruel, Matt Grady, Kyle Wurzel, Rob Schliff, Chad McClinic, Jason Hab, Brian Warren, Mark Beer, Michelle Hirschberger, and Tanya Myers. Homeroom sponsors, please release these students to the Ag Room at your earliest convenience.
The wedding of the year is on November 22nd and 23rd at 7 o'clock p.m. Buy your tickets to Father of the Bride for Mrs. Thornburg and A115 before or after school. Tickets are all $3.
Drama Club members, check the bulletin board for new items needed for the play and reception. We need your help.
There's an excellent opportunity for any student who might be interested in a career in journalism or a media field. It's a summer workshop, it does cost, and it's in Los Angeles, California. But it's an excellent chance to explore media careers and meet media professionals. Check in the guidance office for more details.
Students who were selected to complete on academic Super Bowl teams or study groups should meet with Mrs. Lant in A159 today, November 20th at 3 o'clock.
The following students need to stop by the athletic department to pick up or sign physicals: Gretchen Kripe, Aaron Drum, John Glover, Ross Hensler, Ron Rucker, Ben Aspel, Zach Bourne, Elena List, Jackie Stanton, and Amber Hoover. Please stop by the athletic department.
Reminder, market day pickup will be today, Wednesday, November 20th.
The class rings have arrived. Rings will be handed out tomorrow, November 21st, during lunch hours. Your balance due must be paid to get your ring. This will be the only delivery day. Also, rings can be ordered with a $50 deposit. Samples will be on display.
As you are aware, this is the third day of American Education Week. Today, we will be honoring all faculty, paraprofessionals, and volunteers.
Attention all junior girls. Are you interested in bringing a delegate for the Hoosier Girls State? The program will be during the week of June 22nd to 28, 1997, at Indiana State University. See Mr. Carnes or Mr. Vandry to sign up. Deadline for signing up is December 11th.
Key Club members who want to be a part of the upcoming project should meet during homeroom today if you are not in the C Club. Projects being worked on will be Big Brothers and Big Sisters, the Red Cross, Bloodmobile, and Penny Pitch.
Smoke Signal will be accepting letters to the editor. Students and faculty are welcome to participate. Pay. Deadline for these letters will be December 6th to Mr. Robbins. Thank you.
The following students need to stop by the athletic department to pick up or sign physicals: Gretchen Kripe, Aaron Drum, and Ross Hensler, Ron Rucker, Ben Aspel, Zach Bourne, Elena List, and Amber Hoover. Please stop by the athletic department for certificates.
Thanks. That's all for your Warrior News. Have a great Warrior Day.
What did you do?
Nothing. I stirred the tanks.
Oh.
8. This is Houston. Say again, please.
Houston, we have a problem.
Good morning. This is your Warrior News from November 21st, 1996.
Seniors, the Herf Jones representatives will be here this Friday, November 22nd, to take senior graduation orders. They will be set up in the ticket office during the lunch periods.
Drama clubbers, want to earn some points? Sign up on the bulletin board and bring some cans of pop. Miss Woodridge needs your help. Father Cast, be here at 5:30 tonight.
Today, we will honor all school board members, administration, secretaries, and nurses as part of American Education Week.
Freshmen, on Monday or Tuesday, November 25th and 26th, you will have a meeting with the guidance department during your study hall or teacher aid hour. Periods 1 through 4 will meet Tuesday in the lecture room. Periods 5 and through 7 will be...
Sorry about that.
We had some technical difficulties.
Today we will honor all school board members, administration, secretaries, and nurses as part of American Education Week.
Drama clubbers, want to earn some points? Sign up on the bulletin board to bring some cans of pop. Miss Woodridge needs your help. Father Cast, be here at 5:30 tonight.
The wedding of the year is on November 22nd and 23rd at 7 p.m. Buy your tickets to Father of the Bride from Ms. Thornburg in A115 before or after school. Tickets are all $3.
Freshmen, on Monday or Tuesday, November 25th and 26th, you will have a meeting with the guidance department during your study hall or teacher aid hour. Periods 1 through 4 will meet on Tuesday in the lecture room. Periods 5 through 7 will receive instructions from their study hall teacher.
Drama club members, check the bulletin board for new items needed for the play and reception. We need your help.
There is an excellent opportunity for any student who might be interested in a career in the journalism or media field. It is a summer workshop and it does cost, but it is in Los Angeles, California. But it's an excellent chance to explore the media careers and meet media professionals. Check in the guidance office for more details.
The class rings have arrived. Rings will be handed out today, November 21st, during lunch hours. Your balance is due and it must be paid to get your ring. This will be the only delivery day, and also rings can be ordered with a $50 deposit. Samples will be on display.
Attention all junior girls. Are you interested in being a delegate for the Hoosier Girls State? The program will be during the week of June 22 to 28, 1997 at Indiana State University. See Mr. Carnes or Mr. Vandry to sign up. Deadline for signing up is December 11th.
Now at this time, we have a live shot from our school Skycam.
Looks kind of slick out there, Sean. Key club members who want to be part of an upcoming project should be here, meet during homeroom today. If you're not in a Group C club, projects being worked on will be Big Brothers and Sisters, Red Cross Mobile, and Penny Pitch.
Smoke Signal will be accepting letters to the editor. Students and faculty are welcome to participate. Deadline for these letters will be December 6th to Mr. Robbins. Thank you.
The following students need to stop by the athletic department to pick up or sign physicals. Gretchen Kripe, Aaron Drum, and Ross Hensler. Ron Rucker, Ben Ashpool, Zach Boren, Alina List, and Amber Hoover, please stop by the athletic department for certificates.
That is all for your Warrior News, and not this time. We have an optional video. Have a great Warrior Day.
Would it be a
my whole life to. For I can't help falling in love with you. Like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be.
This is your Warrior News for November 22nd, 1996. I'm Sarah.
And I'm Heather. Attention all junior girls. Are you interested in being a delegate for the Hoosier Girls State? The program will be during the week of June 22nd to 28th of 1997 at Indiana State University. See Mr. Carnes or Mr. Vandrea to sign up. Deadline for signing up is December 11th.
The girls' swim team lost to a powerful Penn team last night, 113-73. The 200 freestyle relay team of Stacy Nogler, Carrie Grothaus, Laura Lundeen, and Jenny Marty tied for first and set a new school record. Other first place finishers were Stacy Nogler in diving and Christine Shivers in the 100 free.
Drama clubbers, want to earn some points? Sign up on the bulletin board to bring some cans of pop. Miss Wolders needs your help.
The athletic department still needs workers for the JV and varsity boys basketball opening game on November 26th. Please call extension 8431 if you are interested.
Girls varsity and JV basketball team beat Elkhart Memorial. JV defeated the Chargers 25-21 and varsity won 66-57. JV and varsity record is now 2-0.
Messages in the main office for Cliff Schwartz, Joe Baumgartner, Mike Oswald, Dan Glazer, Anka Mulder, Eli Schock, Megan King, and Lindsay Schwartz.
Herf Jones' representative will be here today, November 22nd, to take senior graduation orders. They will be set up in the athletic area ticket office during the lunch hours.
At this time, we will be showing you our Wawasee newsreel. This can be an optional video, but we wish you would stay tuned.
Yeah.
Like to promote the opening night of Star Trek First Contact. Hope all of you get a chance to see it this weekend. Have a great Warrior Day.
Everybody come out and see the play tonight. Have a good day.
To be or not.
Get that explosion and fire.
Fire!
This is your Warrior News for November 25th, 1996. I'm Pat McCauley.
And I'm Mary Schulte. The following students need to stop by the athletic department to pick up or sign physicals: Gretchen Kripe and Aaron Drummond, Alina List, Ron Recker, Zach Boren, Amber Hoover, Eric Weaver, Mike Oswalt, Case Endler, Richard Moore, Jared Foley. Please stop by the athletic department and pick up your certificates. Bright Schaefer, Matt Coy, and Eric McFarlane, please stop by the athletic department to pick up your jackets. Annie Meaner and Nate Oosley, please stop by the athletic office. The athletic department still needs workers for the following games: Frost basketball, January 18th. Girls JV varsity basketball, December 14th, December 7th and 21st, timer, and January 25th. Wrestling, December 21st. Boys freshman basketball, February 10th, a timer. Please call extension 8431 if you are interested.
Attention all junior girls. Are you interested in being a delegate for the Hoosier Girls' Day? The program will be during the week of June 22nd to 28th, 1997 at Indiana State University. See Mr. Carnes or Mr. Vandry to sign up. Deadline for signing up is December 11th.
Drama clubbers want to earn some points? Sign up on the bulletin board to bring some cans of pop. Ms. Wooldridge needs your help.
The Fellowship of Christian Athletes will be meeting tomorrow, Tuesday, at 7:15 a.m. in room C-117. Come join us for time of fellowship.
Lady Warrior varsity basketball team extended its 3-0 record on Saturday versus Fairfield. The Warriors were down 27-20 at halftime and came out the second half with an outstanding team effort, both defensively, to erase the 7-point lead of the Falcons and go on to win 61-55. The next action for the JV and varsity will be Tuesday, December 3rd at the home versus West Noble. Freshman girls open tonight in the Hardwood Teepee versus Columbia City at 6:30.
Monday and Tuesday, freshmen will have a meeting with the guidance department during your study hall or teacher aid hour. Periods 1 through 4 will meet on Tuesday in the lecture room. Periods 5 through 7 will receive instructions from the study hall teachers.
Father of the Bride cast and crew, congratulations on a well-done job. Ms. Wooldridge was so proud of you. Be sure to show up after school to strike the set.
The girls' swim team finished second out of 7 teams on Saturday at the Goshen Relays. The 200 freestyle relay of Christine Shivers, Stacy Nogler, Laura Lundeen, and Jenny Marty set a new meet record with their first place finish. Girls practice at the high school, boys practice at Wawasee Middle School.
Jeremy.
Hey, Yonka, what's up?
Guess what I just heard.
Let's see. Our homecoming queen's mom is a Russian spy.
No, dummy. For 25 cents, you can write a Christmas message to your friend.
25 cents? That's a lot of money.
Just hunt up some pocket change and bring it to school with you.
Cool. Now, how much was that again?
25 cents. There's going to be someone selling them at lunch.
Thanks a lot. By the way, where will I see these?
In the Christmas issue of the Smoke Signals newspaper.
Okay, I get it. I'll send a message to my friend.
Remember, Christmas messages, 25 cents, they're being sold at lunch.
So kiss up to a teacher, say hello to a friend, but buy Christmas messages.
Come and watch and cheer your Warrior wrestlers to victory Tuesday as they open their season at Concord. The match will start at 6:30 and should be a good chance to see your favorite Warrior wrestler in action.
That's all for your Warrior News. Have a great week.
Yeah.
Good morning. This is your Warrior News for November 26, 1996.
The following students need to stop in the athletic office to pick up or sign physicals today. Gretchen Kripe, Aaron Drum, Alina List, Ron Rucker, Mike Oswald, Casey Hensler, Richard Moore, Jared Foley, Aaron McFarland. You need to pick up your awards and jacket in the athletic office also. Andy Meyer and Nate Usley need to stop by athletic office. The athletic department still needs workers for the wrestling match on December 21st. Please call extension 8431 if you are interested or know of someone who would want to work. Let's open up tonight, basketball team, rocking and rolling. Good luck to the wrestlers also as they open their season at Concord. Go Warriors.
Next week we'll have our annual penny pitch competition to raise funds for the needy families over the holidays. A collection will be taken every day in your English class next and this week. Each English teacher's class with the highest total at the end of the week will receive a treat from the Key Club and NHS sponsors. So check your piggy banks, relatives, employers for possible donations. Every penny, nickel, and dime, quarter, and dollar, and check will help those in need.
Attention, all junior girls. Are you interested in being a delegate for the Hoosier Girls State? The program will be during the week of June 22nd to the 28th, 1997 at Indiana State University. See Mr. Carnes or Mr. Vandry to sign up. Deadline for signing up is December 11th.
Drama clubbers, want to earn some points? Sign up on the bulletin board to bring some cans of pop. Miss Wooldridge needs your help.
NHS members, more people are needed to sign up to count money next week for penny pitch. Please see Miss Martin if you can help. Thank you.
Market day forms are now available in the main office for those who wish to take them home. They are due back next week, Wednesday. Attention, half an hour power club. You'll meet in the cafeteria annex during homeroom for now, from now on. Midterm grades will be distributed tomorrow during fifth period in the auditorium surge area.
Would you like a little extra cash without having to do any work? Wawasee Decker Club has the answer for you. The club is including a 50-50 drawing at each of the home JV and varsity boys basketball games this season. The tickets will be sold for $1 each or six tickets for $5. The tickets will be sold throughout the JV game up until the third quarter of the varsity game. The winning ticket number will be announced between the third and fourth quarter. The winner will receive half of the money earned. You must be present to win.
At this time, we'd like to make an announcement concerning the large salad bowls that should be returned to the cafeteria as soon as possible. Now, Sean, what's the salad bowl
look
like?
This is a large salad bowl. Please return it to the cafeteria as soon as possible.
Tina, why are you so sad?
How do you know I'm sad, Dan?
Just look at your face.
What's wrong with my face?
You look terrible.
Well, thanks a lot, Dan. You look like the guy in the Dorita commercial. Why do you have that silly smile on your face?
Stop avoiding my question. What's wrong?
If you have to know, I don't have very much money, and I have a lot of people to give presents to. Why are you so happy?
Because I just found out about Smoke Signal's Christmas messages. They're only 25 cents and will be on sale at the concession stand during lunch. They'll only be on sale from November 27th to December 4th.
That's great. Now I have something to give all my friends without spending a lot of money. Won't they be surprised? Thanks, Smoke Signal.
Smoke Signals is again accepting letters to the editor for the next issue. If you wish to submit a letter, please give it to Mr. Robbins before December 6th. All letters must be signed with the writer's real name.
That is all for your Warrior News. Have a great week.
I'm Lindsay.
And I'm Mary. NHS members, more people are needed to sign up to count money next week for penny pitch. Please see Mrs. Martin if you can help.
Market day forms are now available in the office for those who wish to take them home. They are due back next Wednesday. Attention, half hour of Power Club. You will meet in the cafeteria annex during homeroom.
Midterm grades will be distributed today during fifth period in the auditorium surge area.
Would you like a little extra cash without having to do any work? Wawasee DECA Club has the answer for you. The club is holding a 50-50 drawing at each of the home JV and varsity boys basketball games this season. The tickets will be sold for $1 each and 6 tickets for $5. The tickets will be sold throughout the JV game up until the third quarter of the varsity game. The winning ticket number will be announced between the third and fourth quarter. The winner will receive half of the money earned. You must be present to win. And now a special announcement from Smoke Signals.
Oh, cool.
Jackson, look. Our Christmas gift just came from Aunt Wilhelmina.
Great and wonderful joy. My sin for pleasure has been purged. Another stupendous Christmas for four Office Depot items that any boy could ever dream of.
Heavenly Bliss, post-it notes.
Oh, cool. Tape.
I can program my own computer. Hamlet, who wants to read this?
Cookies. 28% butter and desiccated coconut.
Ah! Can my eyes be deceiving me? Have I not truly just died and gone to heaven? Jackson, a WHS Smoke Signals newspaper.
Yes, it is true. Aunt Wilhelmina has blessed us with a Christmas message. But wait, what cheap aunt? They're only a quarter.
Dear Auntie probably just bought them in the concession stand in the Commons during lunch.
We'll have to return this favor by sending her one expressing our greatest appreciation on Monday, December 2nd.
Smoke Signals is again accepting letters to the editor for their next issue. If you wish to submit a letter, please give it to Mr. Robbins before December 6th. All letters must be signed with the writer's real name.
Okay, I'm supposed to wait for the video to come on. Boys basketball results. The JV and varsity boys basketball teams opened the season last night with a pair of victories. The scrappy JV team beat Fairfield 40-31, and the varsity stood Fairfield in the overtime to defeat the Falcons 63-54. Our next game is Saturday against Mishawaka at Mishawaka. JV game starts at 6:15. Your support was great last night. See you at Mishawaka.
The girls' swim team crushed East Noble last night, 125-61. First place finishes were Stacy Nogler, Christine Shivers, Jenny Marty, Laura Lundeen, Cassie Biddle, Karen Shipley, Stacy Kraft, Jenny Brissett, and Tiffany Miller. Now we have a special visitor with us, Jenny Marty, and she has an announcement to make about FCA.
Okay, there's a FCA kickoff Monday night, and we're going to have
food, fun, and lots of games and a speaker. So everybody come out Monday night for FCA and our kickoff. And if you need more information, see Mr. Vandery, myself, Carissa Evans, or Andy Jones. Thanks.
Thank you.
All junior homeroom sponsors are reminded of the guidance video, guidance newsletter, and class sale tabulations being done in homeroom today. Be sure to have a calculator to use. Juniors, if you had a large sale, you may want to bring a calculator to homeroom.
Key Club, don't forget to help with the blood mobile today. Get your pass for Mrs. Pletcher as soon as possible. A reminder to all SRC members.
Deck
the WHS halls at 1 o'clock p.m. on December 1st. Be there.
The Wrestling Express pulled into Concord last night and defeated the Minutemen 57-15 on the varsity mat and 18-12 on the junior varsity mat. Winners were Shane Hyman, Kevin Carr, Daryl Carr, Ben Heisman, Jason Carr, Jamie Salazar, Ken McIntosh, Tim Cotton, and J.D. Lane. All ball. Other winners included Jet Wardinger, Travis Coy, Troy Hendricks, J.D. Davis, and Sean Beelan. Warriors will be in action this Friday to host the Wawasee Classic. Starts at 1:30 p.m. Come cheer the Warriors.
A reminder, today we are promoting the upcoming can drive, so start saving your cans.
The LRC will now be open on Tuesday and Thursday until 6 p.m., starting on December 3rd.
Thanks. That's all for your Warrior News, and have a great Thanksgiving.
And a great week.
And I'll say mine. This is your Warrior News for December 2nd, 1996. This is a month of many splendor themes with the holidays coming. The studio would like to thank Mrs. Leach for taking the time helping us decorate. Thanks.
Hi, I'm Therese Lindeen. If you want to send a sweet Christmas message to a few friends, go to the concession stand in the Commons during your lunch period. The Speech Club will be delivering candy grams suckers with your personal message attached during 6th and 7th period on December 20th. Candy grams will be 75 cents for one, or you can buy two and get one free. Take this holiday opportunity to surprise a friend.
Midterm grade reports can be picked up this week in the guidance office. College representative days will be held this week, 5th period in auditorium. IUSB Tuesday, December 3rd, and IPFW Thursday, December 5th. Market day forms are available now in the main office for those who wish to take them home. They are due back this Wednesday. Thanks.
Would you like a little extra cash without having to do any work? Wawasee DECA Club has the answer for you. The club is holding a 50-50 drawing at each of the home JV and varsity boys basketball games this season. The tickets will be sold for $1 each, or 6 tickets for $5. The tickets will be sold throughout the JV game up until the third quarter of the varsity game. The winning ticket number will be announced between the third and fourth quarter. The winner will receive half of the money earned. You must be present to win.
Smoke Signals is again accepting letters to the editor for their next issue. If you wish to submit a letter, please give it to Mr. Robbins before December 6. All letters must be signed with the writer's real name.
The Warriors traveled to Mishawaka Saturday and came home with a loss and a victory. The boys' JV basketball team worked hard against a taller Mishawaka team in a losing cause. The Warrior boys' varsity basketball team out-hustled the Cavemen in a 51-39 victory. Thanks to those who made the trip. We look forward to this Saturday's opponent, state-ranked DeKalb, here at the Teepee. Hope to see you here along with your enthusiasm.
Two college representatives here this week. Tomorrow, Indiana University of South Bend. On Thursday, IPFW will be here during your fifth period lunch. They will be located in the auditorium surge area.
There will be a meeting this Thursday at 7:30 a.m. for all girls wanting to participate in softball. If you will not be able to attend, see Coach Odell.
The Warrior wrestling team used a total team effort Friday to post a 3-1 record in its own classic. Warriors defeated Northridge 48-24, Columbia City 70-6, Fort Wayne Dwainer 66-12, and Ose 42-30 to state-ranked Belmont.
Leading the way for the Warriors were Chet Wardiner, Daryl Carr, Jason Carr, and Sean Bielan, all 4-0. Sam Crenshaw went 2-0, followed by Travis Coy, 3-1, Shane Hyman, 2-2, Troy Hendricks, 3-1, Ben Hyman, 3-1, Jesse Leonard, 2-2, Jamie Salazar, 3-1, and J.J. Davis, 1-1, and Corey Harden, 1-0. Jason Carr was voted outstanding wrestler in the gold pool. The Warriors will take a 4-1-2-0 in the NLC record to Warsaw Thursday to battle the Tigers starting at 6:30 p.m.
The LRC will be open on Tuesdays and Thursdays until 6 p.m. starting on December. Attention, half hour of Power Club. You will meet in the cafeteria annex during homeroom from now on.
This week we will have our annual penny pitch competition to raise funds for needy families over the holidays. A collection will be taken every day in your English class this week. Each English teacher's class with the highest total at the end of the week will receive a treat from the Key Club and NHS sponsors. So check your piggy banks, relatives, and employers for possible donations. Every penny, nickel, dime, quarter, dollar, and check will help those in need.
Freshman cheerleaders, please see Mrs. Martin as soon as possible. Penny pinch counters, please remember to come to Mrs. Martin's room this week.
At this time, we will show you an optional video of from our TV production advanced speech class. That's all for your Warrior News. Have a great week.
Okay, I'm here with Mr. Warren, who is the sponsor of FFA. Mr. Warren, what is FFA all about?
FFA is an organization for students that have some area or some interest in an area of agriculture.
Okay, what are the requirements for someone to join?
We'd like them to take one of our ag classes to kind of become familiar with what is involved in agriculture, but that's not a requirement. The only requirement is that they pay their dues, and that makes them a member of not only our chapter, but also the state and national FFA organization.
Okay, when do you meet?
We meet first in Group A, the first Wednesday of every month, and also then we meet the second Monday for night.
In the
ag.
What is one last thing you'd like to tell anybody who's interested?
Opportunities at FFA are really very widespread. You can be involved in things from plants to animals, all types of competition, opportunities to travel practically throughout the United States, even judging teams and so forth. They like competition, they like an opportunity to earn some money, if they have an area of interest in any area of agriculture, right? Tell them to come take a look and see what they're about.
Okay, thank you very much.